So it is the all-important and high-voltage eliminator of the Indian T20 League. It is the game of the third-placed Bangalore side versus the fourth-placed Kolkata side, and the winner will be playing against the loser of Qualifier 1. Hello everyone, my name is Shayanto Shengupto and welcome back to another MSP video presented by CrickTracker. I hope you guys are fine. Before we start the video, I would request all of you to subscribe to our channel and also like, comment and share if you like the video. So without further ado, let's quickly dive into the video. Now if you take a look at the probable playing 11 of the Bangalore franchisee, then opening the batting will be Devdutt Padikkal and Virat Kohli. At number 3 will be KS Bharat, who played that glorious innings, who hit that last ball 6 off the bowling of Avish Khan in their last game against the Delhi franchisee. He will be brimming with a lot of confidence and a lot of motivation. At number 4 will be a toss-up between either of Tim David or Daniel Christian. At number 5 will be Glenn Maxwell, who notched up yet another half century and continued his blistering form in the previous game of the Indian T20. Then will be coming AB de Villiers. We all know how much of an impact player AB de Villiers is. At number 7 will be Shahbaz Ahmed, followed with the 4 bowlers in the form of Harshal Patel, who is the purple cap holder, has the most number of wickets in this particular Indian T20, not just for the Bangalore franchisee, in the entire league of its own. Then George Garton, Mohammad Siraj and Yuzvendra Chahal. So a power-packed bowling lineup who can really bowl well lies in store for the Bangalore franchisee. Now if you take a look at the probable playing 11 of the Kolkata franchisee, Kolkata will be high on confidence, will be flying with a lot of confidence because they are coming on the back of a victory against the Rajasthan franchisee and therefore they qualify to the playoffs. Opening the batting for them will be a pair that has played really well in the tournament. Even in the last game they played a solid partnership knock. Opening the batting will be Venkatesh Iyer and Shubman Gill. At number 3 will be Nitish Rana. At number 4, Rahul Tripathi. The top order has performed really well under the astute captain of Captain Morgan. At number 5 will be Captain Morgan in the form of a very explosive batsman, even though he's not really scored runs at the rate he usually does, but all eyes will be on him because if he plays the captain's knock, KKR will actually play well and eventually win against Bangalore. At number 6 will be Dinesh Karthik. Then at number 7 will be a toss-up between Shakib Al Hasan or Andre Russell. We know that if Andre Russell, if he's fit, if he's absolutely fine, then he'll be a no-brainer and Shakib Al Hasan will have to actually sit back. Followed by the 4 bowlers in the form of Sunil Narine, Varun Chakravarti, Lockie Ferguson and Shivam Mavi. The bowling department has clicked really well for the Kolkata franchisee. All the bowlers, be it the spin bowling in the form of Narine, Varun Chakravarti or the express pace of Shivam Mavi and Lockie Ferguson, both the departments are playing really well. Both the departments are playing in tandem and that bodes well for the Kolkata franchisee. Now we take a look at the head-to-head battle between the Kolkata and the Bangalore franchisee since 2008. Then Kolkata have a better position since they've won on 15 occasions and have lost on 13 occasions. But if you take a look at their record since 2018, then it is even Stevens. Both the teams have won on 4 occasions. Now if we take a look at the stadium in which this game will be played, it will be played at the Sharjah Cricket Stadium in Sharjah. The average first inning score over here in the last 5 games is 138, and teams that have actually chased have won on 3 occasions and have lost on 2 occasions in the last 5 matches that have been played over here. Now if you take a look at few of the individual stats, then first if you take a look at Captain Oyen Morgan of the Kolkata franchisee, then he's just 14 runs away from completing 1000 runs in the Indian T20 League for the Kolkata franchisee. Next, if you take a look at Dinesh Karthik, then the former skipper of the Kolkata franchisee needs just 3 more dismissals to complete 150 dismissals in the Indian T20 League. He'd be the second person after MS Dhoni to reach that elusive mark. Next, if we take a look at Harshal Patel, then Harshal Patel is just 3 wickets away from completing the maximum number of wickets by a particular bowler in any Indian T20 League season. The current record is held by Dwayne Bravo. Next, if we take a look at Mohammad Siraj, then Mohammad Siraj is just 2 wickets away from completing 50 wickets in the Indian T20 League. Now, if you take a look at few of the individual player battles in this particular eliminator game between the Kolkata and the Bangalore franchisee, then first, if you take a look at Sunil Narine versus Virat Kohli, Virat Kohli has mustered 99 runs against the Willy mystery spinner of the Kolkata franchisee, and he's been dismissed on two occasions. Next, if we take a look at Yuzvendra Chahal versus Dinesh Karthik, Karthik has been dismissed thrice by the Willy leg spinner of the Bangalore franchisee. And lastly, if we glance through Glenn Maxwell versus Varun Chakravarti, then Chakravarti has dismissed Glenn Maxwell on one occasion. So with that, we come to an end to this particular MSP video presented by Click Tracker. This was the eliminator between the Kolkata and the Bangalore franchisee. It'll be an absolute high octane and high voltage game. But before I go, I would implore all of you to head to our Telegram channel, because this is a place where you'll be getting the best match combos as well as the best cricket fantasy tips. Also subscribe to our channel, because this is a place where it'll be your one-stop destination for all things cricket. Thank you so much, guys. This was me, Shayan Toshan Gupta.